Hey guys, this is Alex and welcome to another product review. This time we're going to be talking about the clutch pedal pivot rod. And this is going to be something that you're going to be concerned if you are driving any kind of 5-speed Dodge Neon or if you're driving the Dodge Neon SRT4. This pivot rod is what pushes on the master cylinder. So this is the clutch pedal. And this is what's behind the firewall. And every time you press the clutch pedal, you are pressing into the master cylinder. That's where the plunger will get pushed. The factory pivot rod, it's a combination of plastic and a bolt, an 8mm bolt. And the issue with the metal in the front and plastic on the back is that the rod in the front is fine, but eventually the back being plastic from shifting or some aggressive shifting will break and you will have problems disengaging your clutch, or you will potentially be left stranded if that breaks. DCR has come up with this solution, which is interesting. It's made out of stainless steel, both this section and this section right here. And this is fully adjustable. So on the factory adjustment was an 8mm bolt that you adjusted, well, loosen up and then allow the rod to come in and out. On here, you loosen this nut and then you turn this rod to control how far or how the length of this. And the longer it is, the deeper you're gonna press into it. The shorter it is, the less deep you're gonna press into it. And that, because of how deep it goes, it controls where in the in relation to the floor the pedal releases the clutch. So you have a lot of adjustability with this without having the concern of this breaking. Though the interesting thing that is unique to the DCR pivot rod is this bearing right here. It's not a normal bearing per se. If you look at this, it actually can move side to side, up and down. So let's look at that. This is what they call an spherical bearing. So this gives you a little bit more of a 360 degree movement, and this will allow you to, well, allow the pedal to compensate for any kind of left to right or up and down movements. So that's an interesting feature that is included on this pedal rod. To install the pedal rod, you first have to remove the old factory one. The old factory one, the front portion is made out of metal, is gonna have a black metal clip that keeps it pretty much mated to the master cylinder. And that, getting that black metal clip out of there can be challenging. You have to remove the dust cover, which is right here. And once you remove the dust cover, mind you, this is underneath the car, where your pedals are. So you have to bend yourself and reach in there, remove the dust cover, and then push a couple of places to release the clip that will release the original factory rod. Fortunately, mine, the clips internally were broken. So as soon as I pulled on it, the whole thing came out. So hopefully, you know, that's not gonna be too much of a problem. But the DCR rod comes with instructions on how to do it, which detail the process of separating that factory rod. And then on the back, the only thing you have to do is loosen up the 8mm bolt and the thing will slide out. To install this bad boy, it's a lot easier. There is nothing on the front that's gonna keep it stuck to it. You literally just push it into the dust through the dust cover and you are almost there. This I will go inside where the clutch pedal goes, and then you would adjust the length of this to decide how far you want your clutch to engage or disengage. To lock those nuts into place, I basically use two wrenches. I use a wrench like that and I use this wrench like this, and then I turn the nut against the body and that locks it in place. DCR recommends that you only adjust it one a little bit at a time, because what can happen is that if you all of a sudden set this very, very long, you're gonna push very, very far out, and that can potentially damage the cylinder, or worst case, can crash your fork and the clutch fork to the pressure plate. So you don't wanna push too far, farther than the original intended design. Also, if you push very little, you will not be able to change gears. Your clutch won't be fully disengaging. So there is a sweet spot, and within that sweet spot, there is movement to go up and down to control how far you want the clutch pedal to release. So the way that I do it, I count the treads, and then I test out if I like the setup, and if not, I pull it out, and I'll back out one full turn, or I'll extend it out one full turn, and try it again. And then once I'm happy with the engagement, I lock it in place. Once this is locked in place and this is installed, I remember you're working inside where the pedals are, so you're upside down, contorted into a weird shape. You are gonna install an e-clip, which is again included with the rod, and the e-clip pops into place and retains this thing into the clutch pedal. I like to use two clips. There is room for two clips, and that's just me being, you know, a super safety guy. So that gives me assurance that if one clip falls off, there's another clip in there. But I think even if both were to fall off, this thing is pretty much secure in there. And you'll see when you install it how tight of a fit can be. To remove the e-clips, I like to use this tool right here. This tool, it's very cool because you have the ability to put it in here and insert. So that makes it very easy to insert without these things flying everywhere. And you also have, if you insert the other side, you're able to release. So you push with this guy and it pops right out. And I love using this as opposed to pliers or screwdrivers, just because this tool is made for e-clips. It makes the job a lot easier. And you can obviously put it, different sizes for different e-clip sizes. So let's look at how this looks underneath the car. From underneath the driver's side pedals, I remove the factory rod and then the dust cover carefully using needle nose pliers to avoid damaging it. With the seal removed, you can see the black cup that held the original factory rod in place. To remove the cup, I gotta remove this e-clip. I use e-clip pliers to get it off. As always, I place the link in the description below to the tools I use. Here's what it looks like with the clip removed. Now, using a small flat screwdriver, I slightly pull out the piston. It is critical to avoid pulling it out too far, as this will cause the clutch fluid to leak out. Now, using a very flat screwdriver, I force it between the black cup and the white piston to separate them apart. Instead of pulling on the screwdriver and causing the piston to pop out and leak fluid, notice how I turn the screwdriver to separate the cup from the piston. After the cup falls out, I reinstall the e-clip using my e-clip pliers. This secures the piston in place. The dust seal is inserted next and pushed in until it's flush. I then install the new push rod and secured it in place with the included e-clip. Now let's go for a test drive. Alright, we are back from the test drive and it went pretty smooth actually. I went around the block and it felt like the engagement was just about right, but I wanted just a little bit more. So I came back, took off the rod, extended it, made it a little bit bigger, one turn. Remember, DCR recommends to turn it just one turn at a time, and then went around again and sure enough, now it's right on the money. So it is a little tricky to get down there and remove it and install it and so on, but really, I mean, that's the same difficulty you're gonna encounter when replacing it with a standard one. And the standard one, the factory one, like I said, is plastic, so might as well replace it with something that is more durable and more adjustable. Well, that's it for this episode, guys. I have a lot more SRT4 videos, so if you like this video, hit thumbs up, comment on any future videos you might like to see, and subscribe if you haven't. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you on the next one.